We are the aircraft for the push. So the A pumps go off, the packs go off, the collision light comes on, parking brake is set, the transponder out, off. Before start checklist.
Before start checklist. Hydraulic A pumps
off.
Packs
off.
Anti-collision light
on.
Parking brake
set.
Transponder
off.
Before start checklist completed.
Okay, we'll call our guy from PMDG till we get the GSX. I was looking at AES, but AES is not so good, I think, because first of all, you can't uninstall it, just put some kind of directory onto your FSX directory, and you cannot really delete it. It's not so great. Plus, only works with commercial add-ons. It doesn't work with standard FSX scenery, so it's not. I don't think it's that good. So I'll look at GSX as well. Okay, so we go in meters. And, we'll turn. Stun number 10. Nose to the left and a fairly short push. ML, it doesn't recognize that. Left 90 degrees. 40 meters is enough total distance. Yep, that's fine. Okay, we'll start the process.
And ground, cockpit. All right, Captain. We're all set to go up here. We've been cleared to push and start at your discretion.
Right there, ready for push. Power and air clear, doors closed. We are ready for pushback. Please park the brake, please.
Okay, parking brake is off, clear to push.
So hopefully he's gonna push nicely enough.
Brake's off, here we go.
Yeah, the push is starting well. Let's see what happens. We'll start the engines. Okay, so starting engine number 2. So we've got N2. Oil pressure. Let's keep an eye on the push. It's gonna push nicely actually. Starting to turn. Good stuff. Starter cut out, number 2 stable, and starting engine number 1. N2. Yeah, the push is a little bit long, he needs to stop, otherwise he's gonna get the tail into the building. So we'll stop. See if he stopped. Yeah, he stopped. Oof. I was close to the terminal building. And back into the cockpit. The taxi line is here. Fantastic. Starter cutout, number one stable. Okay. So, let's go on the overhead. I just come on, probit comes on. RTI says warm enough is not required. Aircount. Auto. Maybe unit goes off. Star switches, they come. Continuous, the EPU comes off. Come down here, the recall. That's good. Flaps is 5. Got a shortcut on the joystick if you're wondering why the flaps are moving and I don't do anything to them with the mouse. This is idle detent. Okay, just wait for the flaps to come to 5 just to make sure. Okay, that's good. We call the before taxi checklist.
Before taxi checklist. Generators
on.
Probe heat
on.
Anti-ice.
As required.
Hydraulic A pumps.
On.
Air cond.
Set.
Isolation valve.
Auto.
Engine start switches.
Continuous. On.
APU.
Off.
Recall.
Checked.
Flaps.
Set.
Stab trim.
Set.
Start levers.
On.
Before taxi checklist completed.
Okay, cool. So, we shall assume we have taxi clearance and we'll be on our merry way. The thrust as much as we can actually. So we'll taxi on the standard FSX scenery via Lima 3, Fox 2, Fox 1, Echo 1 for runway 28. Check the config. We shall assume as well we have the cabin secure. Before takeoff checklist.
Before takeoff checklist. Config.
Checked.
Recall.
Checked.
Flight controls.
Checked.
Flaps.
Set.
Stabilizer trim.
Set.
Take off briefing.
Complete.
Cabin.
Secure.
Engine start switches.
Pause the checklist.
Checklist suspended on your request.
Sorry about the taxiing, it's a little bit all over the place. Trying to do the checklist and taxi this thing around. Sorry. Okay, so the next thing we have to do is tell this guy to do what is called the runway entry procedure. So on Foxtrot 2 now, actually doing alright. And once again, there's no traffic around. I'm flying on my own here. And we assume we have clearance to line up and take off runway 28. Runway entry procedure.
Cabin crew, take your seats.
Continue the checklist.
Resuming checklist. Engine start switches.
On.
MCP.
Set.
Transponder.
On.
Transponder auto.
Auto.
Landing and strobe lights now set. Landing lights.
On.
Before takeoff checklist completed.
That's runway 34 and runway 28. Okay, okay. It's still raining and it's quite windy. The wind coming from the southwest, about 20 knots. Doesn't seem to be any major weather on departure, nothing showing on the weather radar. Just line up. Toga, and off we go. Gear up. Gear up.
Gear coming up. Gear up and locked.
Flaps one.
Flaps one selected.
It would have helped to go on LNAV actually, silly me. Flaps up.
flaps going up.
After takeoff flow.
Ready for checklist.
After takeoff checklist.
After takeoff checklist. Air content pressurization.
Set.
Landing gear.
Up and off. Up and off.
Auto brake.
Off.
Flaps.
Up, no lights.
Altimeters.
Set.
Confirm.
Set.
Confirm.
Disregard the item.
At your discretion, check item discarded after takeoff checklist completed.
So we'll assume as well, we're climbing to 370 now on standard. Not sure why multi-crew didn't recognize the altimeter setting. Sorry. 370. Sure we have one time, twice, and three times up here. Flying around Dublin. Ten checks climb.
Ten checklist. Recall. 10 checklist complete.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay, that was the 10 checks, so now we're all good to go, passing level 100. And now basically we can keep climbing to level 370. EDFB is nicely following the flight. The EFB anticipates stop of climb just after Nipwood. The FMC doesn't really see actually. Yeah. That's all good. That's not too bad, just the RNAV departure. Morning time in Dublin. No bother. At the moment it shows landing in Gatwick with 3.4 tons. So it's not too bad. A 380 view. On camera. So everything's good at this stage. No major concerns. Already about 60 knots of wind, mostly across a little bit on the tail. It's almost a jump seat view. A little bit of turbulence. It's forecast to be a bumpy flight, so we'll keep the passengers strapped on. If you have any questions, please ask them in the comment and chat section. So as I said, this is PMDG 737 NGX in FSX. This is not PPM3D or whatever it's called. You've got a text message. The one thing I need to kind of work out is Top Cat and how it's transferring the load data into a flight simulator. That's a good question, actually. I guess that's the way maybe it is in the aircraft, because I believe in the aircraft it's it can be slightly moved up and right, so it's just the way they set it up there. There's another view as well. Hold on, like this. Today is not so clear, but the other day, like the captain's displays were quite dirty, whereas the FO's display were clean. Today I can't really see it there, but yeah, the other day I could see it a little bit better. That's funny. Anyway, cool. I'm not familiar with the iFly. Just seen a few videos of it online, but I'm not familiar with it. Is it a good? Is it a good one? They are quite like the PMDG 737 NGX. So it's a cool machine. Yeah, it's not too bad. The views you can. I think actually that's an FSX thing, but you can. You can switch the views with keyboard keys and then zoom in and zoom out. But I believe there's a couple of softwares like EasyDoc and TrackIR which actually allow you to move around. I think one of them you can put it on your head and move around the flight deck, but that's not really for me because I would get a bit of motion sickness, I think. It's not too turbulent, so what we might do is release the passengers. There we go. So looking at the ND, top of climb after neck cap and then top of descent there. If I remember, there's a level 270 restriction at Gipso. So I'll set it there. So we already have to start thinking about the descent while we are still climbing. This is crazy stuff. Start preparing the EFB, select the star for runway 26 left and Gatwick, the Astra 4 Delta. Activate now. Then the approach. Six left. Yeah, Astra once again. Now I'll check the actual charts. Gatwick. The chart for the arrival. So we've got Gatwick. No decent path after Goodwood. Okay. Clear that message. Level of first, and then look at the descent. One to go. Here we are, leveling off level 370, decimal 79 on the speed. Everything's good. Look at the approach. So it's travel 270, 15 miles before Birney, which is Gipso, that's correct. Now route Birney and Cumil. Travel 180 at Cumil. 180. It's not too far off. Avant and Goodwood 130 to 50 knots. Is it 130 to 50 knots? At 4,000 or above here. Astra. No, bugger. It's here. Execute. Delete this one. Cycle through the points. Page 250 to 100. Forecast transition is gonna be today check the meter first. Meter Gatwick 920Z, which was about 20 minutes ago. 230 at 16, 14 degrees, 1014. Okay. 4, 70, transition. And the winds in the descent. Pick up a couple of winds. taxi at 290. It would be 276 at 67. 76, 67. At 140. These are winds given by PFPX. 278.55 and level 70. A bit of shear there, the speed is increasing, a bit out of control. The eyesight deviation is minus one on the ground and H of 1014. The engine anti-ice on and off, it's hard to tell, so I'll leave it as is. Runway 26 left. Good. 4 miles. No decent path after Astra. Delete all these restrictions and be downhill. And what else do I want to do? Yeah. Fuel 3.4 plus 57.1, 60.5, a little bit less for the configuration. Let's say 60.2, flap 30 with that right, for auto brake count 2, so it's top of descent 35 miles, and minimums for the approach. Minima 400. Okay. Here we are, 400 feet. So we got VR set, minimums, GNH preset, got auto brake, the FMC is set for the descent, and we can do a checklist. Descent checklist.
Descent checklist. Pressurization.
Land altitude set.
Anti-ice.
As required.
Approach briefing
completed.
IS and altimeter buds
checked and set.
Confirm.
Checked and set.
Confirm.
I confirm.
IS and altimeter buds.
Checked and set.
Confirm.
Disregard the item.
Jumping to the next line, descent checklist completed.
He's being difficult for some reason. That was working good, but he's obviously having a little bit of a block on this one. Okay, not very far from the top of descent now. It's, I believe Bristol down there. No, it's not Bristol actually, that's Exeter. EGDI, I'm not sure what this is. Anyway, it doesn't matter. I'm back to my progress. Wants to descend, reset MCP altitude. Okay. So set 270 first by Gibson. Ah. Yeah, there are three altimeters are linked together actually. Sorry. Okay, and starting the descent. Still plenty of fuel, which is good. The weather at Gatwick is not too bad. It's good visibility and just a touch windy, but it's not too bad. So it's not too bad. It took us about 40 minutes to get going on the ground. Took off at 910 Zulu. Block off at 910 Zulu. Take off at 919 Zulu. And making good progress according to the AFB. That's good. One last thing I forgot. Ah, yeah, yeah, yeah. This is unforgivable. The course. That's a Aivlasoft 270. We are at BNF path, it's 180 by Kumil, I believe. Yep. It's already preset. See the south of England, standard FSX here. The active sky next, it's giving us a cloud about 60 miles ahead, between 60 and 80 miles ahead, which is not too bad. Don't want to be drawing clouds too far. So now transitioning onto the arrival.
Golf Kilo Airport Information India 0920 Zulu Weather Wind 230 at 16 Visibility 10 Sky Condition 1700 Scattered Ceiling 2200 Broken Temperature 14 Dew Point 11 QNH 1014 Advise on Initial Contact with Information India Echo Golf Kilo Airport Information India 0920 Zulu Weather
Okay, so the weather is as expected, 1014, a bit of southwesterly wind, all good. Alright, so after that we set 130 by Goodwood, 250 knots. For some reason, I've got a little error message on the EFB. Some kind of draw polygons, given point is not border rectangle. X equals something and Y equals something. I'm not really sure what this is about. Anyway, approaching 15,000 feet. Strap the passengers back in. That does look a little bit more cloudy now. A little bit of shear as well, the speed is varying a little bit. Watch the heading, like always, try to keep on top of that. So at this stage we should be landing at 1018Z, so in the next 19 minutes. Not bad. So the next restriction is 250 knots, level 130 by Goodwood. We'll try to achieve that. The one is doing a good job in VNAV path, so it should work out. Look around. Not too bad. It's got a few breaks in the cloud cover. And the coastline is not looking too bad. It's all nice. Pretty good. Good morning, Lambert 93. The weather in Gatwick today is partly cloudy and southwesterly wind about 50 knots. Yes, this is FSX. I'll play around the 80s. Let me find the frequency.
Echo, Golf, Kilo, Kilo, airport information. Kilo, 0950, Zulu, weather, wind, 230, at 15, visibility, 10, sky condition, 2000, scattered ceiling, 2600, broken temperature, 15, 2.11, QNH, 1014. Advise on initial contact, you have information. Kilo, Echo, Golf, Kilo, Kilo, airport information. Kilo, 0950, Zulu, weather, wind, 230, at 15, visibility, 10, sky condition, 2000, scattered ceiling, 2600, broken temperature, 15, 2.11, QNH, 1014. Advise on initial contact, you have information. Kilo, Echo, Golf.
Negative, no virtual right now. So it's gonna achieve 250 knots, level 130 by Goodwood quite nicely. Well, almost. Help it with a bit of speed brake. It's not doing a bad job actually. Now routing towards Astra Mayfield for a wide base leg runway 26 left. Which is all good. So at 10,000 feet we'll do the 10 checks. If our dear friend Multicrew Experience will be willing to comply. We'll see how it works out. See if our dear friend Multicrew Experience is gonna do the job requested. 10 checks down.
10 checklist. Recall. 10 checklist complete.
He's done it. Perfect. Good man. Rightio. So we have Could you believe it? Flipping forgot the ILS frequencies. That's not gonna help. Okay, I know why I'm doing this, but it's really bad. So 110.9 we have. We have India Golf Golf. India Golf Golf on the other side. course is 259, 259. Set the QNH 1014. Approach checklist. Approach checklist.
Approach checklist. Altimeters and instruments.
Set and cross-checked.
Approach frequencies.
Checked and set.
Approach checklist completed.
Now it's India Whiskey Whiskey. Okay, what's the actual items? That would help. India Whiskey Whiskey, that's the right one, 259, good.
I will check that, skipper.
No, no, don't check anything, please.
I am at my wit's end with this India Whiskey Whiskey uniform. Okay, confirm Navade ID or frequency.
Disregard.
Anything else I can do?
No, thank you. Right, and that guy needs to calm down. He's gonna cut off an engine and we're gonna be in dire straits. Okie dokie. When he loses the plot, he tends to go for the engines, which is not good. Still a healthy 60 knots on the tail, mostly, about the side. Very good. I can't believe I forgot the flipping frequencies. Well. But I know why I'm forgetting. But bad habits. In the cloud. That's the white base leg. DME 13 miles, a little bit high, maybe. Not too bad though. Flaps 1.
Speed check. Flaps 1 selected.
Flaps 5.
Flaps 5 selected.
Take the heading and self vector. Final term 290 to intercept the localizer.
Confirm frequency. Okay, confirm.
Okay.
What value did you intend?
Disregard.
Ditto, I ignore that.
Vehicle speed. Clear for the approach. Localizer is captured. Runway link 259. Looking good, looking good. Engine 172.5. And the missed approach is 2,000 feet.
2,500.
Terrain is noted. Set these myself. Gear down.
Gear speed check. Going down.
Flaps 15.
Flaps 15 selected.
Flaps 30.
Flaps 30 selected.
Landing checklist.
Landing checklist. Gear down and secured. Engine start switches
on.
Recall
checked.
Speed brake.
Armed.
Landing gear.
Down.
Auto brake.
Set. As required.
Now set flaps.
Set. Grid
landing lights.
On.
Landing checklist completed.
Wish me luck.
600. Minimums.
Up.
Master, caution, anti-ice, reset, no PSEU, light.
Cool, he's done a good job cleaning up the aircraft. Welcome to Gatwick, no bad. Bad. So we'll taxi along runway 08 left. Then take the next exit. We'll go to stand, is it 10 or 12? Just follow the taxi with the FB. Juliet. And then we'll continue on Juliet all the way. Normally the stand should be on straight ahead. So according to the EFB, I'm gonna lose the line to the left there. We want actually to go left. So I'm gonna go across here. And then rejoin the line in the middle there. Here's the line again. Then going to stand number 8. Yeah. The standard FSX scenery. Start the APU.
APU. APU starter active now.
So we're good to stand at number 8.
Pitted heat turned off already. Skipper selected off already. Commander.
Okay, he's losing the plot. See the line? There is no line. That will do. Parking brake set. Two blues. one red. Welcome to Gatwick. Not bad flight, actually. Open the doors. Door is open. Magnificent. Open the doors. Cool. So we'll do the shutdown flow now. The fuel pumps can go off. I can go off. We have disembarked everybody. The aircraft is gonna stay in Gatwick for a while, so I can shut down and secure it. Right, same for the shutdown checklist. Shutdown checklist.
Shutdown checklist. Fuel pumps.
Off.
Window heat.
Off.
Probe heat.
Off.
Anti-ice.
Off.
Electric hydraulic pumps.
Off.
Air conned.
Set.
Exterior lights.
Steady.
Start switches.
Off.
Auto brake.
Off.
Speed brake.
Down.
Flaps.
Up. No lights.
Parking brake.
As required.
Engine start levers.
Cut off.
Weather radar.
Off.
Transponder.
Standby.
Transponder standby. Now set flight deck door.
Unlocked.
Shutdown checklist completed.
So the secure flow, the RS are off, emergency exit lights armed.
Setting localizer 7604.
Okay, he's losing the plot now. We'll get the FMC menu actions, the ground connections, set the chucks, some ground power. Shut down the APU. First of all, put the ground power on the bus. Shut down the APU. And this one can go off.